Welcome to this video demonstration showing how the integration between the Agilent Advanced Design System and the Cadence Allegro PCB design environment can shorten design cycles and improve design quality for RF mixed signal designs. In this video, you will hear Dan Evers of Agilent showing the design flow from an RF design perspective, and Gary Hind of Cadence from a PCB design perspective. You will see that it's not only possible to transfer basic RF circuits, but complete designs with packaged parts, ensuring design integrity, minimizing design entry errors, and simplifying design reuse.
And so for this demonstration, we're going to show a circuit which is a combination of transmission line elements and packaged parts. And we're using packaged parts which were previously imported from Cadence. Again, as we mentioned earlier, this solves a problem that is quite commonly happens when we transfer RF designs into the corporate standard design tool in a mixed signal design environment. The RF engineer may not have used this corporate standard symbol. He may not have used the corporate standard footprint. That requires rework on the part of the Cadence engineer, and also potentially introduces problems into the circuit. So we're using corporate standard schematic symbols, corporate standard layout footprints imported from Cadence in this ADS design, and we'll be then assured that in Cadence we can exactly reproduce not only the transmission lines, but the association of the transmission lines and the package parts. We've got a schematic and a layout in ADS that exactly match, and we're going to do the export to Cadence. Again, we'll do this from the layout environment, file, export. We choose the Cadence PCB option. We say OK. We'll take this directory and pass it to the Cadence engineer for incorporation in our larger mixed signal design.
So we're now sitting back on the Allegro desktop. I have the project manager open, and I'm going to create a brand new design project. So first thing I'm going to do here is, while I'm still in Project Manager, is say import IFF. We'll now use the RF PCB option to import the IFF. So I'm going to select the schematic IFF file, select open, and say next. As well as having MLINs and M-curves, in other words, parameterized RF components, I've also got some discrete capacitors and discrete resistors. Capacitors and the resistors mapping cleanly to my local Allegro component. I'll say next, finish, and we'll start Allegro to create the hierarchical block that contains the RF circuit and also to import the RF circuit in its own right. The schematic opens, I get a blank sheet. First thing I'm going to do is add component, and I will add the parameterized block that we've just created. If we descend into the block, here you can see that we now actually have the RF circuit as well. At this stage, I can say component and add, and I can actually add a drawing page to the design as well. One last thing I need to do, I'm going to call the drawing blank RF circuit, and then we'll say file and save hierarchy. It writes the whole design, works through the hierarchy, and confirms that the hierarchy has been written successfully. So what I've now done is taken the IFF circuit, referenced the circuit through a hierarchical block, and placed it onto the schematic. So at this stage, we're ready to go to layout. So I'll say exit from here, and from the project manager, I'm going to say export physical. With export physical, I want to package the design, and I also do want to back annotate as well when I've completed. First thing I'm going to do is open up a reference design. I'll just go to my ADS transfer directory, go into the demo directory and go into my backup area, and I'll use a design called rfstart.board, and the output will be RF loaded. I need to select the user-defined properties are created because this handles all of the RF parameters, and we select OK. It netlists the design, packages the design, updates, and then actually back annotates the schematic as well. So everything's successful, and we'll start the RF PCB layout. And as you can see, I have a board outline. If I just set up and just show you the cross-section, you can see I have a six-layer board already defined. I'm going to go into RF PCB, go to Setup, map the layers. We are preparing the design in readiness for microstrip and strip line elements, and also in this instance here, dual strip line elements. We say Apply. I'll now go to RF PCB, and we'll say Auto Place. It shows me all of the components, including the discrete components and the RF components, ready to be placed. I'll select C1 and say Start. And if we just window into the design, you can see I now have the whole circuit on my cursor, and I'm ready to be able to place it and place the rotation. And there we have the divider circuit that was created in ADS, imported into a schematic, netlisted from the schematic through to the PCB, and placed in the Allegro database. One last thing I need to show here. If I use the command Show Element and ask for information about elements in design, I'm going to interrogate the symbols. And here you can see I've got a resistor using an R1206. This is an equivalent component directly out of the Cadence library. The translated component that we did earlier in the demonstration has actually come all the way through from the ADS environment. Same thing also applies to the capacitor as well. This is using the CO8805 footprint.
Thank you for viewing this video about the integrated solution from Agilent and Cadence. There are also three other videos covering other aspects of the design flow, including the transfer of RF circuits, the transfer of custom copper shapes, and synchronizing package parts libraries. We encourage you to watch these videos as well to get the complete picture of this integrated solution. And if you haven't experienced ADS firsthand, you can visit this URL to get a free ADS trial license.